a video. I know you're probably thinking, oh great, she's abandoned us again and she's gone, but honestly, I have not had time to do a video until today, because obviously, like I told you, I was away all of last week, and then this week I've been trying to catch up with like Raw and Smackdown, but I've just been so busy, and everything's been so crazy. But no, yeah, the week obviously that I was away obviously was really good. For those of you who don't already know, my boyfriend at the time proposed to me, so we are now engaged, so I've got a nice ring. So that was obviously a massive shock at the start of the week, and I was just like, whoa, did not see that coming out of anywhere. But yeah, no, so that was like really awesome. And then obviously we went back to his, he lives in Cumbria, which is near Scotland, so we went there for a few days to see his family and stuff, and it was just crazy just see, like, seeing so many people. And then on the Saturday we went to Preston, because I don't know, some of you who obviously watched my channel when I first started reviewing might have known that I used to follow a backyard company called UBW, which Liam's actually in. So obviously they hadn't done any like events for like over a year, but they were doing like a taping, so that was the first one I've ever been to, even though, you know, I like started watching it like 2 years ago. It was the first one I went to, so it's actually really kind of weird actually seeing Liam wrestling. But, you know, it was good anyway. So if you guys are interested in it, or if you used to follow UBW, you can watch it. They have put their videos like, on a different channel, so I'll put like a link in the description box. But no, it was a good show. It was really good. So that was, yeah, my week off. So it was really crazy. So obviously then I got behind on Raw and SmackDown, and ended up having to watch like, yeah, three like, or Raw, SmackDown, Raw and SmackDown, like, within like 48 hours. So it's crazy just catching up on like all the wrestling stuff. So if my reviews are a bit of a ramble, then I apologise, obviously, because I've got like 2 weeks worth of like Raw and SmackDown to kind of catch up on. I'm not going to kind of really go through like everything that happened, but just talk about what I think about the storylines and stuff. But obviously the Raw from like 7th of March, I watched that, like, I can't remember when I watched that, so I can't really remember what happened that well, because obviously I watched the other three like over this weekend, but that one I watched ages ago. So I probably already wasted like 2 minutes of video by just rambling about myself. But no, so yeah, the Raw from the 7th of March obviously started with Undertaker. It seems to be a lot of people just responding to people, but they don't really interact. I suppose they're just trying to keep Undertaker and Triple H kind of away from each other until the actual match, which is fair enough. But yeah, so he like responded to him. I did like the video package that they had showing like Undertaker and HBK's like match from the last 2 years. That was pretty cool. So that was good. WWE make awesome like video packages, I have to admit. Even if sometimes they fail on like the wrestling side of things, they do actually make really, really good packages. Obviously, the Orton and Nexus feud is carrying on. Obviously, Orton's just like completely eliminating like all of them. So it's literally just going to be him and Punk at WrestleMania, which I think is good. Because obviously, if you have like Nexus getting involved all the time, it's just a bit like, bleh. Obviously, yeah, so lately, obviously, it's been, obviously, with the Edge and Alberto Del Rio feud, is obviously, Christian's been quite involved in it. Now, Alberto Del Rio has that guy, Brodus Clay, with him. I mean, words can't even describe how much that guy stunk. He's so awful. Obviously, I was watching, like, last week's SmackDown and this week's Raw with Liam, because he stayed over this weekend. And just every time he came on, we were both like, what is this? Does he actually talk? Honestly, I swear all he ever does is, like, every time he, like, does a move or something. And it's like, what's wrong with you? He's awful. They just really seriously need to get rid of him. Hopefully he'll just disappear after WrestleMania. He's just awful. Obviously they had the segment with Michael Cole introducing the guest referee, and of course he fooled the crowd and thinking that it was Austin, but it was actually JBL, which I was quite surprised to see him. I don't know whether he's actually going to be back or whether that was just, like, you know, just to kind of fool the crowd a bit. But obviously, you know, if JBL comes back, fair enough. I didn't really ever like him, but whatever, you know. But obviously Austin, like, you know, did the stunner on JBL and obviously took the contract and signed it, so now he'll be the referee. Which is kind of, it was kind of obvious that was going to happen, but, you know, it's actually quite good just to see Michael Cole crying like a baby when that happened. The whole Daniel Bryan and Sheamus thing, I think it's a bit weird. Obviously, Daniel Bryan beat Sheamus, like, the week before, and then he said that, you know, they'd have a rematch the following week, and if he lost, he'd quit. But obviously, it was for the US title, and obviously, this week on Raw, he actually won it. It was a bit like, where did that come from, you know, because, like, Daniel Bryan's just kind of been the US champion for ages, and then all of a sudden, Sheamus is just, like, bam, and takes the title, and it's like, what? It's a massive losing streak, and then he just wins the title, and it's like, just get him. It's kind of obvious that he wasn't going to quit. I think they used that stipulation too much, really, to be fair, because, like, Vicky Guerrero, like, Dolph Ziggler, yeah, him, Sheamus, and it's just like, oh, just get over it ready, think of some new, like, you know, stipulations you can have, not just, if I lose, I'm going to leave. Vicky Guerrero introduced Dolph Ziggler onto Raw, obviously after him being fired from SmackDown, and then he beat John Morrison in the match, but then the anonymous general manager said, you know, we've given Dolph Ziggler a job, but not you, Vicky, so you have to fight next week on Raw against Trish Stratus, and if you win, you can have a job on Raw. And you knew that was going to be, like, really lame, and obviously, you know, it just didn't really make Trish Stratus look that great, to be fair, but obviously against Vicky, that's kind of hard to actually, you know, get a decent match out of her. But obviously, Lay Cool interfered, and Vicky Guerrero won, so she's on Raw, which is a bit, like, thing is, you know, they made the whole big deal of her leaving SmackDown, and now she's on Raw, and she's like, what? annoying. But yeah, so then obviously John Cena and The Rock, they're still like kind of like responding to each other, and it's just getting a bit like boring now. I mean, obviously I really like The Rock when he came back, but it's just every week it's like, you know, Rock said this, John Cena said this, Rock said this, John Cena said that, and it's just like, get over it already. Although I did find it quite funny when on John Cena pulled out the t-shirt, which said, I bring it via satellite. I thought that was quite cool. Because that's the problem I have, that The Rock is just constantly just doing, you know, not actually being at the arenas. I guess, yeah, okay, he's not actually, like, on, you know, part of WWE anymore, as any host in WrestleMania, but just in the build-up, if you're just doing videos and stuff via satellite, it's a bit, like, boring. But then, obviously, you know, The Miz came out and hit Cena with the belt because, you know, he was, like, all distracted by just saying stuff to The Rock. And, obviously, in this week, The Rock responded with that segment with, like, the little kid, which was, it was okay, but it just felt kind of scripted. It just didn't sound to be, to me, I didn't think it was, like, as funny as, like, The Rock's, like, original kind of stuff. But, you know, and obviously when they had that, like, music playing in the background, like, the ominous kind of music, I was a bit like, what? When has Rock ever had, like, ominous music playing while he's doing, like, you know, like, a promo or whatever? Yeah, so then, obviously, on this week's Raw, Alberto Del Rio was against John Cena, and then at the end, like, The Rock's music kind of hit, and obviously everyone thought it was, like, The Rock that came out, but it just misdressed as him. Well, to be fair, until they actually zoomed in on him, it did look really realistic. It did actually look like The Rock, but then, obviously, as soon as they zoomed in, you were like, definitely not The Rock. And obviously, you know, then he took out Cena. So, yeah, obviously at the moment it seems like The Miz has definitely got the upper hand going into the match. I think that match should probably be quite good. I'm quite looking forward to it. A lot of people, I've read negative reviews about The Miz. They say, you know, he's a rubbish champion, whatever, blah, blah, blah. But I don't know. I'm actually quite enjoying this feud, and I think it should be quite good, to be fair. So that was kind of like what happened. I don't know right off what happened on this picture. Oh, the whole when he brought out, Michael Cole brought out Grandmaster Sexay. Talk about dead crowd. Like, nobody barely in the crowd even knew who he was. Even, like, the older people just were, like, silent, and he was just still dancing and stuff. Like he used to when he was in Too Cool, and it was a bit like, okay, this is so embarrassing. But yeah, I felt sorry for the guy. He's got, like, no reaction whatsoever. It's kind of like when Dusty Rhodes came out the other week on SmackDown, like, not really, he didn't really kind of get any kind of reaction. Sorry, I've got, like, my notes from Raw this week, because we were just drawing all over my notes, so I've got, like, the most bizarre things all over it. Yeah, and obviously Drew Carey's being inducted into the Hall of Fame, and next to it, Liam's written disgrace, which I agree with, because why should he be inducted into the Hall of Fame? Weird. I think I've kind of talked about everything else that kind of, like, happened on Raw, to be fair. SmackDown, yeah, they've obviously, yeah, like I said before, with, you know, the getting Christian kind of involved in the angle, so obviously they had Edge and Christian teaming together last week, which was quite nice, but to be fair, they didn't really do any, like, tag teamy kind of stuff, not that I can really remember anyway, but obviously, I don't know if these people, I suppose, yeah, it was, like, 10 years since they actually tagged together. That makes me feel old. I can't believe it's been that long. Obviously, this whole thing with, like, Kane and the Big Show and the Core, that's what I was meant to say, it's getting a bit weird now. Obviously, the segment that they had backstage with Kane and Big Show was very weird this week on SmackDown, when obviously, you know, Big Show was talking about how they used the team together and that they can take out the Core, and then they obviously went to chokeslam, like, kind of each other, and then they managed to break each other's grip, and then Kane started laughing and said, "You complete me." That was the strangest thing ever. Very freaky, but never mind. They didn't really do that much to build up the Cody Rhodes and Rey Mysterio match. They just obviously had Cody beating, like, complete nobodies. JTG and whoever that other guy was on SmackDown this week, Trent Barretta, I don't even know who that is, maybe someone can enlighten me and tell me who he actually is, I haven't got a clue, but they didn't really do anything for that, and yeah, that's kind of all really, and obviously the main event on SmackDown was a steel cage match between Alberto Del Rio and Christian, obviously, Christian won, because they were both kind of battling on the top of the cage, then Christian kind of fell off, so he won, but then it was Edge kind of came out and was, you know, threatening to, like, attack, like, Alberto Del Rio's car, and then Brodus Clay, like, attacked him, and then Alberto Del Rio did a concerto on Edge's arm on the stage, so that was quite good, and obviously, so they're kind of going into the, yeah, obviously, he's, like, working on, like, Edge's arm, kind of going in with the whole injured arm angle, which is fair enough. And, honestly, I just really hate that Brodus Clay guy. Every time I see him now, I just think, oh my gosh, I can't stand you, you're so awful. He's like a modern-day Rikishi, to be fair. He's kind of like, he does like the same kind of moves, like, you know, like when, like, they're trying to, like, pull him down for a pin, he just sits on them and he looks like he puts him in the corner and tries to run into them, and this is not working. He's awful. Sorry if you people like him. I just cannot stand him. But anyway, I think I'm, like, kind of rambling. I just need to check and make sure I haven't missed anything. No, nothing really else. Nothing else really happened, to be fair. So that was my very kind of short, brief Raw and SmackDown kind of recap. So obviously WrestleMania is like 2 weeks away now, which I'm, you know, I'm really looking forward to. And on my legs have gone dead, I'm obviously sick. Oh, they really hurt, which isn't good. But yeah, so it should be really good. I need to speak to someone at work, see if I can swap shifts so I can actually stay up and watch it. Because, you know, it's not the same. If you don't watch WrestleMania live, it's just not good. I think I watched it. Yeah, I did watch it last year live. Yeah, I did. So yeah, it's not the same if you don't watch it, but... Yeah, so it should be good, and I really must watch WrestleMania 17 and review that, because I said that I would. So I'll try and do that on Wednesday. If not this Wednesday, I'll do it next Wednesday, but I'll really try my best to watch it on Wednesday. It's an awesome pay-per-view, so I don't really need kind of an excuse to watch it, to be fair. But, yeah, no, that's all I was really going to say. I don't think there's anything else I was supposed to say. So yeah, so like I said, I'm sorry that I kept, it's been like 2 weeks since I did a video, but honestly, I haven't had any time to do it until now. So yeah, so thanks for watching, thanks to people who are subscribing to me, you know, you guys are awesome. Obviously, like I said, if you do have any requests and stuff for pay-per-views to review, then I'll try and get around to it sometime. Obviously, so far I've had someone, you know, say, Lose to do Judgment Day 2000, and someone said to watch SummerSlam 1992, which I've never actually seen. So, you know, I'll try and do those. And yeah, so obviously I had quite a few responses to people when they said, like, about their best catchphrases. It seems like The Rock, obviously, got quite a few of your votes, and also Chris Jericho. I can't remember what else, but yeah, no, I think it was like The Rock and Chris Jericho, which you guys seem to think have the best quotes, so that's cool. And I think sometimes, so yeah, I just don't know, I'm going to stop talking because I'm just rambling, not really making any sense. This video is probably going to be really horrible, but never mind. So anyway, so thanks for watching, and I will see you guys when I next do a video. Bye!